Hello, I'm Justin Smith, and I'd like to share a few helpful tips for using model-based definition, or MBD, with feature templates. Here we have a part with a port that we'd like to make into a feature template. You can see that the port already has some dimensions. Dimensions that are inherited from sketches tend to be more robust for use in feature templates. Before we start making the feature template, we will need to map a feature template library and customer defaults. I have already mapped and named two native libraries. If I have TeamCenter integration, I can also map to feature template libraries on TeamCenter. Once I have added the path for a feature template library, I can hit Apply or OK. However, for these changes to take effect, I'll need to restart NX. I've already added the feature template library, so I'll just hit Cancel. Once I have my feature template libraries mapped, I can open Template Studio Author under Tools, Parts and Features, then Feature Template. If I would like to make a few changes to the feature before making a template or need to exit from the author, I can exit here. Otherwise, I can start making a template by selecting the relevant features. In this case, I select the placement CSIS, the port, then create a whole and unite. Since I have selected Add Dependent Features, all the dependent features from what I have selected will also be included in the template. I want to make sure I select Add Dependent PMI. This will automatically add any associated PMI. That way we don't have to manually add them later. You can see to the left that PMI entities have been included in the feature template. Now I want to configure the user interface to make the feature template easier to work with. I'll change this title to select an existing CSIS. This feature template will add a connecting port to design geometry. For the purpose of this demonstration, I'll just name it sample port. Once I have typed in the name, you can see the name of the user interface is immediately updated. Changing the template name will change the file name of the saved template. You can see the changes have updated the user interface. These titles are a lot more helpful for anyone using the feature template. Then we need to go to the template location. The template location is the library we saved the template in. We can see the libraries I mapped out earlier here. Selecting a library allows me to view files within them. We want to save the template here in NX2212 feature template. The last thing I need to do here is define the orientation of the PMI using an existing CSIS that has a similar orientation to my current design. This way, when I place it, the feature will come in the same orientation. Once everything is done, I finish the template and save it. Now that I have a template, I want to open another part to add the feature to. We'll add the feature to this main housing. I can drag and drop the port from the reuse library. You can see the user interface we created earlier. I can place one or multiple of these ports. For this case, we'll just place one. So I select a point and a horizontal reference. Now we have a feature with model-based definition included. In this demonstration, we created a feature template library, then added a feature template from an existing feature with MBD. I then placed the feature template into another part with MBD included in the part. Thank you.